This is how I transform myself from being seen as Casanova to being seen as a successful entrepreneur. During my high school, I had a huge performance drive. I always wanted to be the best in sports. I wanted to have the highest grades. And I was also quite good with girls. But during the lessons, I never really paid attention. So people saw me as a Casanova with a bad working posture. At the graduation ceremony, I sat in the audience with the other students. School made a presentation and a following question appeared. Who's the biggest Casanova of this school? I looked around me and everyone was looking at me. I looked up and I saw that I was the answer. And for me, it was a turning point. That isn't the way how I want to be seen. My adventure started back in 2016, when I sat in a train on my way to a party in Enschede. I looked out the window and was suddenly thinking, how cool would it be if there was a swim short that could change color when it gets in interaction with water? That means that if you jump in the water with a yellow one, you get out of the water in a blue one. Just to clarify, I still had to go to the party, so I was not drunk. But I thought, I just want to have that swim short. So I grabbed my phone, looked at Google, but I couldn't find it. And as enthusiastic as I was, I said to myself, well, Tom, why don't you make that swim short? First, I did a lot of research, and it took me a while to find out if it was even possible to make a swim short with the ability to change color. Besides the information I found on the internet, I still had no idea what I was actually doing. I simply didn't have the knowledge. So what I did, look for people who do have the knowledge. Knowledge about swim shorts, about chemistry, about fabrics, about printing techniques, branding. I told everyone about my idea. And within no time, I had a huge reach. I was able to get in contact with almost everyone I needed to talk to. And I also had a huge advantage because I was young. And people like to help young people. And it's still one of the most underrated personal marketing strategies there is. To simply tell people how old you are. One of those awesome men had his own screen printing company. I told him about my idea, and he said, Tom, if you make sure you have every raw material and you have a piece of fabric to apply it on, we have the equipment, just come over and we can help you to develop that product. And I thought, whoa, great. I have a supplier of this color-changing magic stuff. I only need a piece of fabric to apply it on. So I boarded the train to Amsterdam to visit the supplier, and I sat down next to an old woman, and we had a good talk. I had to sit next to her because it was pretty full on the train. And from all the talking, I got very thirsty, so I wanted to grab some water out of my bag, and I leaned forward, looked under my chair, and I saw a lot of things, except for my bag, because it got stolen. And everything was in that bag, everything. My laptop, my keys, my wallet, my sketches, my samples, and even got worse because I didn't save my files on the cloud. So everything I had worked for in the past 6 months got stolen. And then I realized that I had two options. One, go home and be very disappointed, or go to the store and make sure that they have every raw material so I can start testing. Because I wanted to make that product, I believed in it, I wanted to make it happen. And it was a good decision. Because 2 weeks later, we started testing, and it turned out to work. I lost a lot of information, but I also, within 6 months, had a color-changing fabric suitable for a swim short, as a result of to continue to believe in myself and believe in my product. I thought, if that is possible, I can also make a number of swim shorts which I can test during the summer. And I achieved, together with my grandmother, because she made a few swim shorts for me and my friends, we tested them the full summer. And it was a nice summer day in 2017, and I went swimming with my friends, and suddenly one of them asked me, Tom, what happens if I pee in my swim short? And I said, I don't know, but that had to be tested. So I have a color-changing fabric that changes color when it gets in contact with water. Pee is also... And before I could realize it, he was already standing there peeing in his swim short. I hope you can imagine it, because it was quite funny at that point. But those things had to be tested. But good news, it isn't visible, so don't be afraid. And after the summer, With all the feedback that it obtained, I've been working hard to further develop that product. And the next important thing for me was to find a method on how to raise money for the production. And for me, it was crowdfunding. Raise money, sell products, and build a brand all at the same time. And I also set a goal for myself, a goal where I wanted to enter the market with my product. And I realized that I was much more productive, because the only thing I really had to do was follow the schedule I made for myself, step by step. And before I could go live, I had to make a video, and therefore I needed working prototypes. You're the first to hear it, but the swim shorts in that video, with which I raised almost 30,000 euros, were still made by my grandmother. So that proves that you don't need thousands of dollars to start a company. You only need to convince a number of people that you're able to make that product. Time flies, and before I could even realize it, it was that day. The day my crowdfund campaign was about to go live. And it was a really exciting day for me, because it was the world validation of my idea. I never did a market research, and it was never proven whether people really should pay for my product. But I went live by a huge surprise, because within 13 hours, I already raised the required amount of 15,000 euros, and it got picked up by a lot of media. And right now, as we speak, we're in production of those swim shorts. It's 2 months ago, and I've already sold more than 600 pieces in more than 20 different countries. And every day I woke up, the first thing I do is look at my phone to see if by the time I was sleeping, I've already sold some swim shorts. And I don't know why, but I sell a lot of swim shorts in South Korea. Those things are really cool. But you have to understand that at first, that wasn't my goal. My goal was to prove people that I'm more than just a Casanova, because it wasn't the way how I wanted to be seen. But the only thing I really had to do was to convince myself that I'm more than just that. And now I'm standing here at the red carpet of TEDx, telling my story as a result of to continue to believe in myself and in my product. Along the way, there were a lot of people who didn't believe that I was capable of doing it, because they thought, Casanova, he can do it. Who said, who wants to have a color-changing swim short? Who there isn't even market for. Even suppliers told me that it wasn't possible to make a swim short with the ability to change color. But that doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how other people feel about you or what they say about your product. The only thing that really matters is how you feel about yourself. Because if you really believe in yourself, I can guarantee you, your product will follow. And that is something I think my story proves. Thank you.